Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again. Today, I am super excited because I finally got my hands on the all-new Analogue Pocket, and we're going to be taking a look at it. If you're not familiar with the Analogue Pocket, then you've probably been hiding under a rock because there's thousands of videos online about it right now, and everybody's calling it the best Game Boy Advance ever made. And I gotta say, I'm really loving the Pocket. I've had it in my possession for the last 2 days. I've done a lot of testing on it, and yeah, this has definitely turned out to be one of my favorite handhelds of 2021. As you can see, I did opt for the white version, and you know, I kind of wish I would have went with the black version. Those white bezels are a bit distracting, but overall, I still think it looks really nice. So if you're not familiar with the Analogue Pocket, straight out of the box, this will play GameBoy, GameBoy Color, and GameBoy Advance cartridges. But Analogue does sell separate adapters for Game Gear, Neo Geo Pocket Color, Atari Lynx, and TurboGrafx-16. But right out of the box, GameBoy, GameBoy Color, and GBA. And basically, the only thing you get with the Pocket is a small instruction booklet, a couple stickers, and a USB Type-C charging cable. Overall, I do love the form factor. They've definitely taken a lot of cues from the original DMG, but this is very modernized, and in my opinion, it's very minimalistic. The screen on this is absolutely beautiful, and we'll get into those specs in just a second. It's definitely a high-resolution display on this unit. We've got a really nice D-pad, the buttons feel great, and overall, it's been a comfortable experience playing this for long periods of time. Now, when it comes to I.O., on the base of the unit here, we have USB Type-C, we've got a 3.5mm audio jack for your headphones, and they've also included a GBA link connector. Now they do sell a dock for this that allows you to connect this to a bigger screen. It'll do 1080p over HDMI, but unfortunately when I pre-ordered my unit, that was already sold out, so I couldn't get my hands on one. It's also got dual stereo speakers, and over here on the left-hand side, we have our volume control and our power button. Moving over to the right-hand side, we've got our other speaker and a micro SD card slot. Unfortunately, out of the box, you cannot play ROMs from a micro SD card. We have to wait for jailbroken firmware, but you know, I'm pretty sure that we will get something for this unit. And on the back here, we have our cart slot, which, like I said, out of the box, will do Game Boy, Game Boy Color, and Game Boy Advance cartridges. So let's go ahead and boot this up and take a look at the operating system real quick. On the initial boot up, you will have to agree to some terms of service, but overall it's pretty quick, and this thing does boot up really fast. So when it comes down to it, the Analogue Pocket is not using emulation to play these Game Boy and Game Boy Advance games. It's actually using FPGA technology, which basically perfectly mimics the original hardware. If you're familiar with Analogue's other consoles, like the Super NT and the Super SG, this is actually using the same FPGA chip. And actually, they've added an extra FPGA in here just for developers. So if you head over to their website, you can register for interest right now, and you can port your own cores over to this, and hopefully that comes up soon, but I'm sure we're going to see a lot of awesome stuff running on the Pocket. So before we jump over to the specs, I do want to show you how beautiful and crisp this screen is. I mean, they've done an absolutely amazing job choosing the correct display for this unit here. We'll just go ahead and start up Leaf Green. Carts start up super quick here. I mean, it's reading it directly from that cart. It's not dumping it. This is not emulation. It's using an FPGA to play these games. Now, the sound on this is great. We've got those dual stereo speakers. It does get quite loud, and it sounds absolutely amazing. Alright, so at any time while playing a game, if you press the Analogue button near the bottom of the unit, it'll bring up our menu. From here, we'll go to Settings, Systems, since we're using a GBA game, we'll go to GBA, Video, and Display Mode. Now, we've got three to choose from. This is the Analogue GBA. Personally, I love the way it looks. Definitely makes it pop. We've got Original GBA. Does give it that Original GBA screen look. And we've got the SP101 look, which is the best looking stock Game Boy screen that you can get, but I really do love what Analogue has done with their own setting here. We've also got a frame blending setting, we can change the sharpness, and we can change the position of the screen. Now when we move over to a little bit of game testing, I'm gonna leave it like it came out of the box. It's got that Analogue GBA look to it, and sharpness was set to 3 from the factory. But first things first, I want to get into the specs real quick. So when it comes to the screen that the Pocket is using, this is a 3.5-inch LCD at 1600 by 1440. This is 10 times the resolution of the original Game Boy. We have 615 pixels per inch, so this is a really sharp display given its size. It's got a 4300 milliamp hour battery, and they're claiming 6 to 10 hours of gameplay. It really depends on what system you're playing on this. And when it comes to the FPGA side of things, like I mentioned, this does have two in here. We've got the Altera Cyclone V. This is the main FPGA used by Analogue itself. And they've also included a Cyclone 10, and this one's going to be dedicated just to third-party development. I really can't wait to see what people come up with. So I did want to test a few of my favorite GBA games out on this unit. First up, we have Spider-Man 3. I know it's a little odd, but I really do love this game. I used to play it all the time. I think the graphics are great for being on a Game Boy Advance. And I hope it's coming across okay on camera, but seeing it running on this high-resolution display really does change the game. Next up, this has to be my favorite Game Boy Advance game. It's actually one of my favorite Super Nintendo games. We have Yoshi's Island. And it's running really smooth here. I mean, it's just like I've plugged this directly into a Game Boy Advance SP with a better screen. And for me, this was always a really fun version of Pac-Man, but the main reason I wanted to show this off was just the color palette here. This was a very colorful game, and it's definitely popping on this display. Another really cool feature that Analogue has added to the Pocket is the ability to play your own GB Studio games, or other people's studio games. And with the latest release of GB Studio 3.1, they've added the Pocket Export, so if you do want to make your own Game Boy game, it's actually really easy to do. This is kind of a drag and drop system. There's a lot of games out there right now, there's actually a lot of really good games. And some developers have released their own source code, so really all you need to do is download that source code, import it into GB Studio, and export it as a Pocket file. That way, you can play those games directly on the Analogue Pocket. And I've done that with one game here. So I've just taken it, I've exported it as a Pocket file, placed it on the SD card here. And if we go into Tools, you'll see we got two options. Nano Loop, we'll take a look at that in a second, but we're worried about GB Studio right now. It's going to detect it on my SD card, and we can play it from here. This is known as GB Doom by Calavera Studio. I'll leave a link for it in the description. And when it comes to playing DMG games on the Pocket, we do have a lot of video options here. So we'll head to our settings, video, and we'll go to display mode. First up, we have the Analogue GB. That's what we saw at first. We also have Original DMG, which gives us that beautiful puke green color. I really love this. I think they did a great job. Original GBP, which is the non-green, it's just kind of a grayscale. Original Light, looks pretty decent. And we also have a Pinball Neon Matrix color scheme, which looks more like a Virtual Boy in my opinion, but it will look really good with some games. But in the end, the Analogue GB setting that they've worked out looks really, really good. We can also change the color scheme, so here we have grayscale. We've also got mint. I go to blue, and it's definitely more of a purple unless I'm really colorblind. Green is kind of the way to go with this. Or we have purple, which is red unless I'm colorblind again. But I'm kind of partial to that Analogue GB setting with that green palette. So yeah, this is GB Doom by Calavera Studio, and I think it's actually a really awesome little concept here. I love the sprites they've created here, and we've even got our bunny up here, which gives us a little bit of an upgrade. I did notice as soon as I walk into this room here, I got a big slowdown, but once I get rid of this skull, the slowdown completely stops, so hopefully that can be fixed in the future. But this was exported with the first release of GB Studio that allows us to export to the Pocket format, so you know, that might have something to do with it. I've checked out GB Studio, and they do have a couple demos that you can actually just edit in your own sprites with, your own logos and things like that. I think it's going to be really cool to see what everybody comes up with. And if you do end up making a game and you want me to test it out, let me know in the comments below. And by the way, from any game, we can go right to the menu and quit game from here. It'll bring us right back to the Analogue OS menu. And real quick, I did want to show you Nano Loop. This comes preloaded on the Analogue Pocket. I'm not a music creator, I've never made chiptunes in the past or anything like that, but I could see this come in really handy for some people who love to do this. And by the way, Analogue does sell a MIDI cable for the Pocket so you can interface with different devices and you could use Nano Loop with that device. Or if you have any of the cord carts for the GBA, I'm sure that would also come in really handy. But this is Nano Loop, I'm just going to go through it real quick, throw in a couple different tones here and see what happens. So overall, I'm also a huge fan of the Analogue Pocket, like most of the people who've taken a look at this so far. It's my favorite retro handheld of 2021, but it does come at a pretty steep price. Now, when I pre-ordered this, it was $199, but the price has increased a little bit due to the price of parts going up. It's actually $219 now. And I completely understand that that's pretty high for a handheld like this, but you are getting a quality unit. I mean, they've done an amazing job. It doesn't feel cheap. It definitely feels like a premium item. Now, I know there's a lot of people out there waiting on a Jailbreak for this thing, and as soon as it's released, I will do a video on it. There's a lot of stuff that I want to run on this, and, you know, I'm going to keep an eye on development. You know, third-party development here should take off pretty soon, as soon as people start getting these in their hands. And I suspect we'll see more systems running on the Pocket. But that's going to wrap it up for this video. I really appreciate you watching. Like I mentioned, as soon as a Jailbreak is available, I will do a video on it. I know it's going to be released soon, and it might even be up by the time this video goes live. I will leave a link in the description to the GB Studio in case you want to create your own game. I'll also leave a link to the Analogue website. But if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. And like always, thanks for watching.